that you all came out to support the art department. This is a fundraiser for our department. And of course, we are so excited that these amazing magicians want to do this for us. And I'm sure that many of you have had them in classes, and you're so excited yourselves because you've seen all their amazing card tricks and disappearance and everything like that. But my understanding is a lot of these tricks tonight, none of you have ever seen. So I think it's going to be amazing. Before I introduce all of them, I have two business announcements. One business announcement is there's going to be a blood drive in the middle of the month. May 16th is when they're taking signups in Blue House. The blood drive itself is on the 17th. The other thing is I know there's a lot of seniors in the house, right? Woo! Right? So, your t-shirts look amazing. Chandler Ferris is one of the artists, as well as Darion Barnes. That t-shirt, which looks amazing, is on sale, as you probably know, this week, and then next week is the last week, so I want to make sure that you guys buy it so you have it for Senior Spirit Week. Okay, without further ado. Oh, I also want to, just one last thank you to our administration. All of our administration is very supportive of the arts, particularly Dr. Kenner, so thanks, shout out to them. And last, most importantly, for our magicians. So, as you know, and you guys have witnessed all this amazing excitement in class, you've never seen all three together. And that is what makes tonight incredibly special. So, Sam Redman, Simon Black Toby, and Rachel Wagg.
True.
My day? Well, I've been a bit nervous, kind of all day. Yeah, I don't know why.
Well, see, my boss does a super awesome trick.
What is it?
It can make a red silk appear out of nowhere.
No way. Well, my boss can help you do that. Mine can't do anything by itself. However, it can help yours.
Well, what's the point of your box? It can only help.
It's kind of like a cover sheet on the bed.
Well, let's try it. Come here.
All right, let's see. Normal science fair board.
Careful, man.
Eh.
All right.
Ready?
Ready.
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 Ready. So, yeah. Oh. Change it right now, or don't change it. You got it?
You good with the ace of spades? All right, great. So I'm gonna see if I can, let's see here. I'm gonna fan the deck out sort of like you did, and there should be one card face down. Am I right? Was it this ace of spades?
It's amazing, gosh.
All right, good job.
really, really concentrate on that part, okay? I'm gonna need that serious face that you make when you pretend you're really listening to your grown-ups, okay? And I'm gonna need that super concentrated face. Alright, I'm gonna try to get an impression on the card, okay?
Yes.
I have with me a magic rope. But a magic rope is nothing without its magic scissors, which I still happen to have in my pocket. Got it. Not very impressive, I know, but wait. All you gotta do is put the magic rope by the magic scissors and snip it in half. So now I've got two separate ropes. But you've seen the magic scissors, not the magic rope. So here's what we'll do with the magic rope. They should just sort of together like that. You'll see it right in front of your eyes right now. Just like that. But that's not all it is. Check it out. This makes absolutely no sense to me, maybe it'll make some sense to you. But if I have two ends over here, no ends over here, I take one end, goes into my hand. Sort of just throw it along the rope, one end comes out over here. Now I've got one end on this side and one end on this side. Doesn't make sense yet, but wait. Last end, right into my hand like that. Throw it in there, and catch it, right over there. So now I've still got this magic rope. However, one thing you never, ever do with a magic rope is take the ends off. I am a professional magician. I should be able to do something about this. Okay, here's what we're going to do. First person, I'm going to go down the rope like this. First person to tell me when to stop is where I stop. Not now. All right, on the count of three. One, two, three.
Stop.
Here.
Stop.
Right here.
Stop.
So I've got this little loop right here. Okay. Hopefully this works. If it doesn't, I'm sorry. Grab the ends. We can actually... Oh, I'm coming undone. Grab the ends, and we actually just put them right back on the rope. So now I've got my rope. However, some people like the ends, or some the little loop, and some people wonder how it's done. I'll actually tell you. From this, all you gotta do is get some static, a little static electricity. Hey, this is serious stuff, man. On each end of the rope. And you'll actually see this happen right before your eyes, it'll just connect like that. But I still have this little loop, and that's no good for anything unless you're a cowboy and you're trying to lasso some cows. So, I came prepared, if I can find them, with extra ends. I know, I think things are a little too much, but that's okay. Look. Takes a professional magician to do this. Position the ends right there, they're on. What, you don't believe me? No, seriously, look. But there is one problem. We've been talking so much about the ends of the rope that the center of the rope feels a little detached from the rest of it. So what we need to do is we need to show the rope, the middle, that the rope, the ends of the rope do care. So what we do is we take the ends and we let it help the center of the rope by being a doctor and wrapping it up real good. Perfect. As I said. These will be sold after the show, Magic Rope, for $1 million.
You have to understand. like, this whole night is really hard for me. I'm not supposed to swear. If any of you know me, I'm very quiet now because that's like 50% of my vocabulary. Like, this is really tough. This is really, really hard. Thank you. And my other goal tonight, besides hopefully you get your $4 worth, is to top my father's college magic show. Minus the strobe lights and Stevie Wonder. So this drink, it's a bed sheet. It's a bed sheet. You want to inspect it? It's a bed sheet. I promise you, it's a bed sheet. I'll probably get a Target. I'll probably get a Beth Beyond. But those are really expensive. They're like $40 in breadcrumbs. Yeah, so you guys know Houdini. If you don't, okay. He always did those escapes, right? Handcuffs,
his
milk or something,
and his
cat.
No, the cart wasn't milk in it, it was water, you know?
Oh.
That would just wouldn't be weird, he could just drink his way out of milk.
He has handcuffs,
though,
he probably did. Whatever it was. So stupid, we're not gonna do that. Milk's gross. Okay. So this is a different kind of escape. Yeah, great. Ready?
Your father's
okay.
Here.
So, let's go. We're rolling. Let's go. Okay, so you're going to see Houdini. Okay.
All right, don't fall. She dizzies really easily, so when we're going to grab this, we got to do it really slowly, so I'll go as fast as I possibly can. Go, 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 go.
Yellow.
So, regular bugs, one inspected books from the library. It was, wow, $17. Okay. Why don't you take it? Corey, design. You open the book, any page you want, go tell me the page, show them. He's very light with the hair. You, right there, in the orange. Here, let's see your face. Okay, you are going to pick two other people to come up on the stage, and I'll turn around. Like, I wanted to be unplanned enough, but I'm not interested.
Patrick!
And what's your birthday?
I'm gonna need two people.
Right here!
Alright, keep your hands up. Someone I don't know. Now, what I need you to do, what's your name? Danielle, I will probably forget that by the end of the night, I'm sorry. Okay, what I need you to do, name, John. Okay, what do you, come with me, right over here. I need you to stand on the opposite side of the stage from her. Go back over there. You guys cannot be close to each other whatsoever, okay? Take your glasses off. Thanks. Put them, like, on your pocket or something. Just don't forget them. Don't worry. Okay. What I need you to do is just close your eyes for me. Close your eyes, okay? I'll keep them closed. Now, she is still all the way on the other side of the stage, right? Okay, good. Just keep your eyes closed for me and keep them closed. Watch. I'm going to do something here, but he is not going to know what it is. Okay, John, do you feel anything? Are you sure you can feel anything? Something on your nose? Okay, what did it feel like? Or maybe a piece of hair? Open your eyes. Did I ever touch him? Tell me, what did I do? And somehow he felt it. I don't know how that works. Thank you guys.
Yeah, John.
Sure. Here, go ahead and sign either of these things.
Yes, sign whatever you want. You can write me here.
Oh! Oh!